That's a nice old day here today in Canada, and we're gonna do a little bit of an experiment. This old ATV of mine, this Player Sportsman 500, is on its last legs. The four-wheel drive doesn't work. There's a hub out in the back end. The starter's gone, the Bendix is gone. I can just start it by hand. The carburetor needs a diaphragm, and the cam is worn on it. It's just not warranting putting any more money into this machine. With your regular 50-50 coolant, you'll get water boiling in and around your cylinder. It doesn't really transfer the heat away from the cylinder into the coolant. You've got those little pockets of air, and you get really quick overheating, and then you get engine damage. Now with this, it doesn't boil over till about 330, 350 degrees, something like that. You can check it out online. You still have that contact with the coolant on the metal that draws the heat away, and you don't get the engine damage. They said, Louis, if you go over 260 degrees, chances are good that you're gonna either melt some part of a water pump housing if it's plastic, an impeller if it's plastic, or who knows what else that's in that system. We will remove the radiator from the circuit. We'll just loop it right back into itself. If you put this coolant in it to try to fix some kind of a cooling issue you have, because it overheats all the time, it's not gonna do it. It's not gonna help that. It's not what it's for. It's here to make sure that if you do overheat it for some reason, your rad gets plugged, something goes down, and you don't have enough time to really figure out what it is before it gets overheated, it's gonna protect you. One of the really cool things about this product is that there's really no pressure in the system when you're running at your normal operating temperatures. Very little. You pop the cap, it just sort of goes. You gotta get as much of the old stuff out as you can. If you have a really complicated system, you can use the fluid prep for getting the old stuff out. This coolant is a lifetime coolant. It'll outlast you. You never need to replace it. It doesn't have all those little things in there that break down like your regular 50-50 coolant. It doesn't have any corrosive. The next thing, you wanna blow your motor out with some low kind of pressure air. You don't wanna be pumping 200 PSI into that. I'm just gonna sort of hook it around the fittings and see what I can blast out of that engine. We tried to go digital, but we had issues with our digital gauge. So we just went and bought this one locally. That's plumbed right into the cylinder. Right there, you can see that. And this is right to the water, or the thermostat housing. It goes up and over to our reservoir. Fill it up this much, might use up a little bit. We'll have to maybe top it up, not quite sure. And then it goes back down into the water pump. Disconnected that there, it's right in the water pump. That gauge has been pinned for four minutes. Still idling, boys. So that is it. Evans Coolant, an amazing product. We stand by it, we run it in everything. Everything we have here has Evans Coolant in it. If you want to buy Evans Coolant in Canada, make sure you go to www.kimpex.com. We're gonna wrap this up. This old girl, oh, I don't know, maybe I'll give them to my son and he can play with it. Have some fun, right? That's it. Let's shut her down, Jamie.